So let's see the differences between HBase and Kudu. So both are the technologies at the storage layer. And if you see, HBase stands for Hadoop database, and Kudu is a name given to our storage engine from cloud era. HBase is developed by Apache Software Foundation, ASF, in year 2008. Kudu is developed by cloud era in year 2016. HBase is based on a concept that we can have millions of columns and billions of rows. So here, this is based on a concept called big table. Millions of columns are possible. But Kudu is not based on big table. So that means it can have only limited number of columns. Here you have limited number of columns, maybe few columns. Usually in a table, you will find like maybe 20 columns, 50 columns, 70 columns, but not like millions of columns. So Kudu is not based on millions of columns. Kudu table can have few columns, like maybe 50 columns or around 100 columns maximum, but usually less than that, but not like millions of columns. Apart from that, HBase is based on Java. Java is like a first class citizen here in HBase, and even it is having a prerequisite that Java must be there. But Kudu does not require Java as such. You can use prerequisite to install it. Does not require Java, and we can actually install it directly on operating system, install it on OS. So that means the performance is better. So it does not require any JVM, so there is no problem of garbage collection and other things. Apart from that, HBase is very good for use cases where we have random read and random write. Kudu is good for both random read, random write, as well as sequential access. So Kudu gives you ability to perform sequential access along with random read, random write. Now, when a technology can give you both sequential access and random read, random write, so this is like when you are doing batch, when you want high throughput, then sequential access is very good. And random read, random write, when you talk about random read, random write, it's like maybe a kind of near real time, or you can say you are doing quick lookups, quick lookup. You want low latency. So this particular thing gives it a very interesting feature which simplifies Lambda architecture. It simplifies Lambda architecture because in Lambda architecture, if you remember, like there are two layers, batch layer as well as streaming or speed layer. So if you are using the same technology in these two layers, batch layer and speed layer, then you are simplifying Lambda architecture. HBase is built on HDFS, but Kudu does not require HDFS as such. So for low latency querying, Kudu can be one of the preferred options. Now, which one will you choose when? So if you have structured data, and with maybe few columns, because the data model for Kudu is relational data model, but this one is column family oriented. So this is having a semi-structured data, so this is much more flexible. So this is column family oriented, and kind of flexible. So that means like if you have semi-structured data. Then you may go for HBase, right? And if you have completely unstructured data, then you can go for file system like HDFS. So hope you got this idea that which one we will choose when to choose Kudu and when to choose HBase.